What do we need to make hollow figures? Chocolate, of course, but what else? It has to have the right liquidity. We choose the liquidity in function of the size of the hollow figure. For small and medium-sized figures, 3-drop chocolate is sufficient. It'll give the right coating shell, a good shrinking force, and it can be easily unmolded. For larger figures, we should use a chocolate that's less liquid, i.e. 2-drop chocolate. The advantage? A denser coating shell, meaning you don't have to cast the mold twice in order to arrive at the right density, and you'll save time. 2-drop liquidity is needed to lend chocolate its shrinking force and help it unmold from its form. And of course, we also need molds. The best are polycarbonate molds. Why? Because they provide our finished product with a nice glossy sheen. They eliminate the warmth of the chocolate better, and there's less of a risk of spots due to refrigeration. The transparent molds are quite handy, as they help you keep an eye during the refrigeration process. The conical molds are also quite handy, as they fan out towards the opening, making it easier to unmold the chocolate. Be careful when using high molds. Why? Because the heat rises and is trapped inside the mold. The chocolate might then turn gray. How can you prevent this? By turning the mold in time so that the warmth can be let out or the mold be put in the fridge on time.